Gordon McDonald Partridge. There was once a small boy called Wilfrid Gordon McDonald Partridge. And what's more, he wasn't very old either. His house was next door to an old people's home, and he knew all the people who lived there. He liked Miss Gordon, who played the organ. He listened to Mr. Hodgkin, who told him scary stories. He played with Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. He ran errands for Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. He admired Mr. Drysdale, who had a voice like a giant. But his favorite person of all was Mrs. Nancy Allison Delacourt Cooper, because she had four names, just as he did. He called her Miss Nancy and told her all his secrets. One day, Wilfrid Gordon heard his mother and father talking about Mrs. Nancy. "Poor old thing," said his mother. "Why is she a poor old thing?" asked Wilfrid Gordon. "Because she's lost her memory," said his father. "It isn't surprising," said his mother. "After all, she is 96. "What's a memory?" asked Wilfrid Gordon. He was always asking questions. "It is something you remember," said his father. But Wilfrid Gordon wanted to know more. So he called on Mrs. Gordon, who played the organ. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something warm, my child, something warm." He called on Mr. Hodgkin, who told him scary stories. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something from long ago, me lad, something from long ago." He called on Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something that makes you cry, my boy, something that makes you cry." He called on Mrs. Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something that makes you laugh, my darling, something that makes you laugh." He called on Mr. Drysdale, who had a voice like a giant. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something as precious as gold, young man, something as precious as gold." So, Wilfrid Gordon went home again to look for memories for Mrs. Nancy, because she had lost her own. He looked for the shoebox of shells he had found long ago last summer and put them gently in the basket. He found the puppet on strings, which always made everyone laugh, and he put it in the basket too. He remembered with sadness the medal which his grandfather had given him, and he placed it gently next to the shells. Next, he found his football, which was as precious as gold. And last of all, on his way to Mrs. Nancy's, he went into the hen house and took a fresh, warm egg from under a hen. Then, Wilfrid Gordon called on Mrs. Nancy and gave her each thing one by one. "What a dear, strange child to bring me all these wonderful things," thought Mrs. Nancy, and she started to remember. She held the warm egg and told Wilfrid Gordon about the tiny speckled blue eggs she had once found in a bird's nest in her aunt's garden. She put a shell to her ear and remembered going to the beach by tram long ago and how hot she had felt in her button-up boots. She touched the metal and talked sadly of the big brother she had loved, who had gone to war and never returned. She smiled at the puppet on strings and remembered the one she had shown her sister and how she had laughed with a mouthful of porridge. She bounced the football to Wilfrid Gordon and remembered the day she had met him and all the secrets they had told. And the two of them smiled and smiled because Mrs. Nancy's memory had been found again by a small boy who wasn't very old either. Wilfrid Gordon McDonald.